What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over how to play and even how to install the Ice and Fire mod onto your Apex Minecraft server. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every video we upload, just like this one. When you're playing through a vanilla Minecraft world, challenging the Ender Dragon is often the final test of your strength. After that, there's not really much to do. While many mods and plugins have existed to add more to the game, most of them are not as thorough as Ice and Fire Dragons. As the name implies, the mod focuses on adding ferocious dragons in your world to slay or to tame. In addition to this, the mod features many other structures, items, and mobs to keep you on your toes. From cyclopes to pixies, every corner of your world will have something new to experience. And with Apex hosting, it's easier than ever. To start off with, we're going to jump onto the Ice and Fire CurseForge webpage. When you jump onto here, there's going to be a files tab, which you're going to want to click onto. From here, there's going to be a little tab that says view all. Once you scroll down and click on that, it's going to give you a pop-up where you can sort by version. And here we can select the version that we want. So we're going to just do 1.12.2, but you can do any version here that's available. All you need to do is just click the little download button to the right of the file that you want. And it's going to take you to a secondary download page. And from here, you're going to have the file automatically download. And then you can just click and drag it to a folder that you can easily locate later on. Somewhere like your desktop is fine. For this to work, you're also going to need to download different dependency files. Ice and Fire isn't going to work on certain versions if you don't have mods like L Library or Citadel. L Library is needed for versions of Minecraft 1.12.2 and below, and Citadel is needed for 1.15.2 and above. So for this example, we also will be installing L Library. Now that we have our two mods downloaded, Ice and Fire and L Library, we can hop onto our Apex server panel and then click on stop. Once your server comes to a full stop and is fully offline, then we can make sure that we have the right version of Forge for our server. We're running 1.12.2, we can check that at the top, and then we can also scroll down to the game file and make sure that we're on the right version of Forge. Now that we're sure, we can click on FTP file access on the left-hand side of the screen. And then log in with your information. Once you're logged in, go ahead and find your mods folder and then click into it. And once you're in your mods folder, you're going to find an upload button on the top left. And then on this page, you can open up the folder that you downloaded Ice and Fire 2 and L Library or Citadel if you're on a different version. Click and drag your mods over to the right hand side of your web page and wait for the mods to load 100%. And 2 out of 2 files. Once they're fully uploaded, you can click on the name of your server at the top of the page, and then either click on start or restart to get your server back up and running. Today, we're going to be going over how to simply install it on your regular version of Forge that you have installed on Minecraft. We already have guides on how to install Forge onto your Minecraft launcher. So if you need those, you can just click on the links in the description below this video for more written guides. What you're going to want to do is hop onto your Minecraft launcher and then click on instances at the top. Here you're going to find your version of Forge, and there's going to be a little folder button to the right of it. Go ahead and click onto that. Once your folder opens up, you're going to look for the mods directory or folder. Then click into it and then open up the folder where you have your files located. That's Ice and Fire and L Library for us. Click and drag both of the mods into your Minecraft mods folder, and then click back onto your Minecraft launcher. Now that you have your mods installed, you can simply click play. Once you load into the world of Ice and Fire, you're gonna immediately notice a ton of new features added by the mod. Some of the most notable are gonna likely be the various structures that can be found all over your world. Stuff like the dragon skeletons. In deserts and cold biomes, you're gonna find various dragon skeletons across the ground. These once powerful creatures can be right-clicked with an empty hand to harvest the items directly. With this, you can craft different tools and weapons for use within the mod. And then of course, there's Gorgon temples. You're gonna find a strange stone structure with nothing in it. These broken temples are often found within beach biomes by pulling a nearby lever. A stairway to the lower level will open, providing a chance to fight the Gorgon. And then the Cyclopes cave is found near beach biomes, and it has gold, chest, sheep, and the Cyclopes itself. Be wary on approach, as the inhabitants are not friendly. And then there's dragon roosts. They can be found across every normal biome in the overworld, often spawning multiple dragons. These areas tend to be very dangerous. Ice roosts are only found in colder biomes, while their fire counterpart is found in almost every other biome. While approaching is dangerous, the various gold and chests tend to balance it out. But here's where the mod shines, with the many mobs that it adds. Like the Pixie, primarily spawning in Pixie villages, these small creatures are easy to spot with their glowing particle effects. While completely peaceful in nature, they will often try to steal items from you while you're looking away. They can be tamed by dropping cake nearby, allowing them to follow you around and give a status effect. This mod also adds the Hippogriff, a neutral creature that can be found in a variety of colors depending on which biome you find it in. While they normally only attack when provoked, if they're hungry, they're gonna attack nearby mobs. They can be tamed by dropping rabbit feet, which allow you to give them chests and a saddle. And if you're ever deep underground and spot glowing eyes staring at you, chances are you've encountered a troll. Once spotted, the troll is gonna unleash a roar and rush at the player, dealing massive damage. Their largest weakness is sunlight, which is gonna turn them into stone. While very dangerous, the prospect of obtaining their weapon is very alluring. Then there's the sea serpent. It's a truly terrifying foe, hostile to all who enter its aquatic territory. They're gonna swim towards their prey to take a large bite or fire a jet of boiling water for distance targets. As if that wasn't enough, they're gonna leap out of the water and cause massive damage when landing. And there's also the Gorgon. It's a human snake hybrid that lurks underneath the beach temples. Anything unfortunate enough to lock eyes with her will immediately be turned to stone, losing any armor in the process. This can be combated with a blindfold, but this is gonna cause her to increase aggression and inflict damage and poison. Upon death, the Gorgon head will drop, allowing you to petrify many other mobs. Then there's the Cyclopes. These gigantic monsters are gonna spawn within Cyclopes caves, but can also be found wandering throughout the world. It's gonna attack almost every mob that goes near it with a large roar. They're gonna stomp and kick and bite in order to inflict massive damage. To get close, players can use sheep disguise armor and sneak to get through the gaps. And finally, there's dragons. The main premise of the mod, the ice and fire dragons, are a force to be reckoned with. Whether they soar through the air, use the elemental breath attacks, or simply bite, you're gonna want to make sure that you're prepared. In addition to their hostility, dragons will gain increased health and strength as they develop larger. If you manage to obtain a dragon egg, you can hatch and tame one to wield their abilities for your own adventures. Ice and Fire is truly one of the best mods out there, up among the greats like Pam's Harvest Craft and the Create mod. And Vivecraft too, that's an honorable mention, that's one of my favorites. Ice and Fire, with its dangerous mobs and dangerous locations, add tons of adventure to a game that needs more. And it does it artfully. Well folks, we hope you like this video. That's all we've got for you today, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.